In May, the government laid before Parliament a proposal to borrow up to $608.66 million from the World Bank and ADB to finance the Greater Kampala Metropolitan Area Urban Development Programme. Today, the Committee on National Economy, which is scrutinizing the loan request, went to Kira Municipality to establish justification for this loan.
Do we have a total of all the 106 kilometers, or Kira, or the Ministry of Works is undertaking half of it, like the minister told me?
They held a meeting between the official Ministry for Kampala Metropolitan Affairs, led by the State Minister for Kampala, Kabuye Kyofatogabye, and Kira Municipality leaders. Kabuye Kyofatogabye told the committee that 16 roads measuring 106 kilometers are to be constructed in Kira to relieve Kampala of intense traffic congestion.
Minister of Works was supposed to take that road up to Groba and Isanji, but the funding is really not there. So what we've done, we are going to take it on from Wachiso, connecting to the KDB, the ADP road, Sentema at Bokasa, then we connect it to Bulova.
Over 611 kilometers of roads are to be constructed under this project in municipalities surrounding Kampala City, including Kira, Entebbe, Makindye Ssebugabo, Nansana, Mukono, and parts of Kampala. The program will address challenges of flooding, traffic congestion, and signalized junctions and poor road infrastructure, among others. However, Kabuye Kyofatogabye has urged the people of Kira to volunteer land for right of way in places where roads are going to pass because the government has not allocated funding for compensation.
So I request leaders, let's talk to our people. We get consent on time for the right of way so that we don't bog the program. If we perform better, the members are ready to give me more money and we work. And then we account after our rules to implement, then we account to the masses.
Kabuye Kyofatogabye urged municipality leaders to take the mantle to convince citizens to sacrifice land for development. He guided leaders on the best method to secure authentic consent from citizens to avoid cases of double standards.
I understand a few people are still hesitant. And please, I beg you and I urge you, better surrender, better give us a right of way, because we are going to delay the opportunity of having a road. Just imagine this one.
Ben Onyiga, the town clerk for Kira Municipality, told the committee that they have had engagement meetings with project-affected persons and secured some consent, although some people are still resistant.
We've often and we commit to engage the landlords to give free consents for us to extend, to widen the road extents without compensation. In any case, there is no provision in the budget for compensation under World Bank funding.
Committee members, led by their chairperson, John Bosco Ikojo, noted that they only need assurance of availability of free land for the road projects for them to clear government to go ahead and secure funding.
You mentioned that to be diplomacy and negotiations with the people that are going to be affected. So the clarification I want from you relates on what procedure.
I'm also impressed that Kira Municipality is doing well in terms of revenue mobilization, and they have an allocation of about 1 billion shillings on roads out of the local revenue collection, which is something really good. Only that we have requested them to look at roads, because Kira Municipality is one of the fastest growing municipalities and growing at the rate of 10.4.
The program also seeks to upgrade strategic interconnecting road junctions, drainage channels, markets and workspaces in order to improve the Greater Kampala Metropolitan Area productivity and livability for sustainable socio-economic development. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.